All right. That was just in the spirit of the times. That was just a little bit of gun violence, a little from back in the day. That Bruce Springsteen song, Nebraska, about the, I don't know, maybe the quintessential, you know, that inspired Natural Born Killers. The couple that just thought it was really fun to, you know, take a sort of shotgun and just go blowing people's heads off throughout the Midwest. For no, you know, not terrorists, not no real reason, you know, no political cause, just it was fun.
Hmm.
So, yeah, it's like I say, a little bit of an Alice Cooper-themed lyric from Bruce Springsteen. I thought a little bit of a novelty there. But we were talking about, well, actually, I think we have our subject for a future show.
Old slurs.
Old slurs, antiquated slurs that have lost their meaning over time. Nurse Misery, I make a note of that. Maybe, you know, within the next couple of episodes, we'll go back to that. But we are talking Star Wars. We're trashing George Lucas. We are talking Star Wars. We're talking pretty optimistically. I think everyone at the table is, you know, cautiously optimistic about the new movie. You know, we're not expecting it to suck. It's going to go down the middle. Some good stuff, some stuff we're going to complain about. Kind of like Jurassic World.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. Are those people still in line?
They might be still in line. I was banned from showing up at any of these movie theaters after I threatened to pie them in the face after you countered saying that it was an act of terrorism. I had a...
I'll tell you, and you know what?
Son of a gun. I now have a restraining order against all these movie theaters. Thank you, George Garner.
No, Chuckles, I saved you from Guantanamo.
Yeah, maybe, but now I got a restraining order.
That's the least that could have happened.
Now I got to go see the movie in Canada.
And I'll tell you.
Oh, Canada.
I said that as a joke, right? And just to remind our listeners or refresh with our listeners that weren't listening to that episode, you know, we were joking around here at the table, and Chuckles, you know, as a clown, said, you know, it would be a great idea to get a few... shaving cream pies, you know, nothing lethal, shaving cream pies, and basically bombard the people that were stupid enough to stand in line for 2 weeks waiting to get in to see this middle-of-the-road new Star Wars movie. And it sounded all like good fun. And I'll tell you, 20 years ago, you would have done that.
Yep.
We would have got plenty of video for your show, you know, for your Chuckles and Laughs show. And all would have been well. Everybody would have laughed right up to the law enforcement agencies and the president of the United States. Right. Everybody would have had a big laugh. I was joking when I said that it would be viewed today as an act of terrorism. I was kidding. I thought about it.
Damn liberals.
I'll tell you, Tony Jones, like, am I off base in wondering if, I mean, we're seeing 5-year-old kids thrown out of school because they bring toy guns or pictures of soldiers to school. That's why, you know, the more I thought about it, I said, maybe this is like truth within a joke. I mean, what was that latest one? A kid was expelled from school. Like, he was like 5 or 6 years old. Probably wasn't the latest one. They keep doing it. But, because he brought a hat with little plastic soldiers on it. Because his dad was a Marine, and because he brought little plastic soldiers to school, he was suspended because the little plastic soldiers were holding guns. So, in light of that culture in which we exist right now, I don't know. I think I was just looking out for you in
you
real
saved
life there,
me.
Chuckles.
You saved me, but you cost me a lot of money because now I had to go get a border pass. I got the movie tickets, and I have to pay to go in the bus to travel up to Canada.
Right. Now, don't be bringing the shaving cream and the pie crust up to Canada because I know you. You're just going to bombard the Canadians. You'll start an international incident.
Canadian bacon all over again.
Unless Canadians have more of a sense of humor and take themselves less seriously than Americans.
Well, they're more polite.
They are.
So they might take it with more grace and tact.
They do have, like, nudie bars that, they're basically open to anybody. They don't have age restrictions on it. So
really?
So you're going to bring a bunch of shaving cream to a strip club. So,
yeah, why not? Yeah, shave that beaver.
Now, that's enough.
Well, I mean, that's how you know your stripper is fresh and clean before you bring her home.
Oh, yeah. You just plop some of that in. If it fizzles out like Alka-Seltzer, you run like a turkey.
Oh, no.
Well, I was thinking more on the lines of, you know, we can sit around the stage, and if any of the strippers show up with an exceptionally large bush, we can just pelt them with the shaving cream pie.
There you go. I'm down for that.
Get the idea, lady.
Star Wars stressed with large bush.
Yeah, my last couple of girlfriends were shaved. It took me a while to get used to that, but I guess it's the thing now. You know, more and more women are, yeah.
Yeah, mine.
Any
mine.
Woman over under 70.
Yeah. If you only,
not quite
if you're
true,
shave
it's,
your legs, why not?
I'll tell you.
Keep going. It's easier.
If you say so. I don't. All I know is that the first woman I was with that was completely shaved, it gave me a weird feeling.
We
it
are did. Siamese, if you please.
I would say it gave you another feeling, but the cops would be at the door after I said that, so I won't go there.
Well, no, that's where I went.
I know you're hinting at it.
And I'll say it right out. In other words, like,
you hear school bells in the background.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, what, is it only me? I had that weird moment. You know what I'm saying? The first shaved woman I was, you know what I'm saying? The first one. It was like a disconnect. It's like, this isn't the way it's supposed to be.
Supposed to look different.
Well, it's supposed to look different. Yeah. No, I don't mean that there's supposed to be jungle tropical foliage down there.
That's kind of terrifying.
Yeah, that's terrifying. I'll tell you, especially when you can't find it.
Yeah, like there's just sweat and smells. And
it looks like the swamps at Gabogon.
Yeah, you hear the sound of like parrots and monkeys squawking in the as you're rooting through there.
And you see Yoda dumping off the hairs.
Hiding in there.
Yeah, it's like you're glad you got a condom on because you don't.
Now that's an act of terrorism.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You feel like you need a body suit.
Exactly. It was terrifying.
It's
so,
not a new thing for me though, because all my dead bodies are hairless anyway. So I guess they were setting the trend. For the young ladies here.
A trendsetter, as always, Chuckles the Clown.
Yep. I knew it.
He waxes them when he pulls them out of the ground.
No, I whack them when I pull them out of the ground. I don't wax them.
All right, so it looks like we're wrapping up now at this point. At least we're wrapping up the Star Wars talk.
Definitely wrap that up.
Yeah, wrap up the Star Wars talk. Okay, we're wrapped. The Star Wars is wrapped. We'll talk about this next time. What date is the movie debuting, shall we say?
It's on the 16th. It comes out the Wednesday. Oh. We got tickets for the Thursday.
I'm happy.
I believe
with
some movie theaters it debuts on the 16th.
Friday. I think there's probably like a midnight release on Wednesday and then airs on Thursday.
All I know is there were some tickets for the 16th and there's some on the 17th and there's some on the Friday.
It probably varies per location. We'll do it that way.
All I know is the rest of the movie theaters, why bother going into those? Because there's going to be no one watching anything else besides Star
Wars.
Imagine
having the release that's also coming out that day.
You're done. You're done. You might as well just open every movie theater in there and put Star Wars in there. Why bother?
Well, you know what would be best is there's going to be at least one person that waits at the end of the gigantic blocks-long Star Wars line to see something else.
And he's going to be pissed he missed it.
Yeah, they don't realize that that's only the Star Wars line. And, you know, they were waiting to see whatever other release, like Tony said, whatever other movie was released on that day.
Also debuting tonight, The Hills Have Eyes 3.
Right, and there will be somebody waiting for The Hills Have Eyes 3 at the end of the blocks-long Star Wars line. This actually has happened.
That's how you know they're a terrorist, because if they're not in line to see Star Wars, they're not American.
No, that's how you know they're a moron, because this has actually happened.
They're too stupid to be a terrorist.
It wasn't
for
the movies, but it was for concert tickets. I forget what it was. It was something like the Rolling Stones, Lady Gaga. You know, like, what's the matter?
You don't hear that?
I heard the moaning of some kind of.
It sounded like this.
Thought it was one of your ex-girlfriends.
Well, it did sound kind of cow-like. There's no question about that.
What the hell?
There it goes again. What type of show do you put on, Mr. Garner?
I'm not putting that on. My eyes are getting wide. That's really
demons, cows, haunted cows.
Are we almost out of here? Because, how much time we got, Tony?
We're out of time.
Okay. All right, let's just get out of here. Play whatever's next, and let's get the hell out of here.
Do I have to play what's next?
Actually, yes. You're a victim. Or unless you know what? All right, in honor of all the, let's just say, the weirdness going on in the world, let's go play the Leonard Cohen Future. Tony, can you grab that one?
Thank you, Mr. Garner. I owe you one. I won't make you mad with the Ewoks anymore. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ewoks are off the list.
Okay. On behalf of Chuckles, Nurse Misery, Tony Jones, and yours truly, George Garner, this episode of the Haunted Cabaret is concluded. We are getting the hell out of here. If you never hear from us again, something happened.
Oh, we froze to death.
Something. Yeah. Hopefully you will hear from us again. All right. Nighty night. Now we don't let children die.